Hi, this is Russell Stannard from teachertrainingvideos.com. Today I'm going to show you some really simple design tricks that you can use to make your Moodle course look a lot more interesting. I'm going to base it on a real example. I'm going to show you a real example first, and I'm going to take you through a few of the things. This is actually going to be a two-part course. In this first part, we're going to look at making a really nice header, making it look really consistent, laying out the text in a nice way, and then embedding a video from YouTube, and also show you how to resize that video so it looks really nice within the format of your course. Then we're going to go on to show you one of the tricks that's most misunderstood by teachers, which is the book format, but that will be in unit part two of the course. Let's get straight into it. Really hope you like the video. If you do, please like it, please share it, please comment on it, and of course please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Let's get started. So a couple of really simple things that I do here. We've got a course where we've got like an opening block. I've just got some information here with a nice logo at the top, and then some writing, and then I embed a video. And then if you notice each unit, what I do is with each unit, it looks like this. So what I've got here is a title, and then I've got these little lines, and then I've got this logo in the middle. And I do that on every single unit, and then I basically it's like a kind of flipped classroom. You've got like the video here to the content, and then the exercises that you can either do at home or in class. And if we go to the next unit, then it's exactly the same. So that consistency thing is one of the biggest things when you're trying to design. Now, I'm not a great designer. What I can do is make a course look solid and nicely organized and easy to navigate. I'm just going to go through a couple of little tricks that you can use to make your design look a bit nicer. And I'm going to start by just going through how I do this, because I use this kind of method all the time. So here we've got an empty course in block mode. We've got here the kind of intro section at the top, and then we've got three topics. I'm going to concentrate at the moment on the topics, and all I'm going to do is click on edit, and I'm going to edit topic. So it's that kind of block look at the top. And how do I kind of make all this look a lot nicer? Well, the first thing I do is I do a line. So I'm just going to put a line across the screen. Then I'm going to drop down one. Now I'm going to add in a picture, but I always make my pictures exactly the same size, always for the introduction. That's 150 pixels wide, so it's a pretty small picture. So I'm going to click here and add in a picture, and just jump and choose a picture. Now if I jump to my images, you'll notice see I have a whole box here of what I call small images, and these are all built to 150 pixels wide. I'm going to choose this one here, and I'm going to then upload that image into the screen. Okay, so now I've added this image in, and the next thing I'm going to do is, I mean, there's a couple of ways that I can do this actually. One way to be kind of do this very cleverly is to just click here on the code bit, and then underneath, after the writing, write whatever title you want to add. So it will, as soon as the image is finished there, you can just write in. So I'm going to put this here, flipped classroom unit one. You'll see in a minute why. And while I'm here, I might as well just do this. I'm just going to copy that first line. Okay, and I'm going to put it underneath here. I'm going to paste that in again. All right, and I'm going to then just simply update that, and you'll see that all updates on the screen. Now, actually, in this case, let me just check that. Put that there. Okay, that. And what I'm going to do is actually put that on the same line. So if I just click there and then click. Now, the only reason I do that sometimes it's really hard to kind of click and get the text in. So I always add the text when I'm just doing the titles, always add the text like that and just write it in myself. Okay, now one thing here is that what we can now do, play around a little bit with the font. Try, as I've said, to always be consistent. So I'm going to select that font, and I'm going to click here, and then I'm going to choose, say for example, heading 2. And I'm always going to use heading 2. Now often when I use heading 2, and I've put 3 P's there in flipped, often when I use heading 2, I mark it out and also make it bold, and it comes out nice and thick then. Okay, so there's the heading to my first unit. Now another thing, if we just come back to that topic, okay, is that we can look a little bit into the colors as well. For example, if I select that here and then I click on, I always get this wrong, it's this button here, we should be able to change the color. Okay, so let's say I don't know what color we're going to use, but let's just put it into this color for now. And I can do the same even with these lines here as well. So if I want to change those, I should be able to change them to the new color as well, I do believe. Let me just check. And then I'll do the same with this one here as well. Okay, just clicking on it just to confirm. So that way, suddenly we've got a kind of atmosphere in terms of the font sizes and the lines all being linked to the images. And if you look back at that last example I showed you at the beginning, that was also in a sort of light blue color. So that's one of the ways that we can kind of create a nice title at the top. Really easy to do, but it really, now what the thing, important thing with that is that you would consistently do that with every single unit of the course. So you would need now to do the same with the second and with the third one. And of course, now you need to add the content underneath. So my next tip would really be around now kind of organizing the intro. If we jump back to the course that I showed, we can see we got this kind of part of the top here, which I've already showed you how to do. Then we've got some text. In this case, we've got a video, and that video's all been lovely kind of badged as well. And then we've got these two buttons here. And I'm gonna kind of show this very clean look and how we can do that, okay? So I'm just gonna take you through adding up in a video, but then also making these nice buttons that link to content. And I'm gonna show you a little trick that we can do here with the content by using the book format, and I wanna show you that. I'm just going to update these and choose better colors for these, okay? So I'm going to click here, always clicking on this button here. I'm going to use this one here, okay? So just tidying all that up a little bit just to make it look a little bit better. Okay, so I'm going to use that kind of blue. So often is the sort of blue I use. Now, when I'm kind of starting to build the content, I'm always thinking in a really kind of organized way. So I'm going to write the word introduction here, okay? And when I write that word introduction, I'm going to select it and make sure that we got header 3. So my introduction's always going to be the same, header 3. Okay, and then I'm going to add my text underneath. Now I want that new color, sorry, so I'm going to select that there, come again to here, make sure everything's consistent. Now the writing underneath, I'm not going to put in the same color. I'm just going to paste in some text really quickly. So just to save myself some time, I've already copied some text. I'm just going to paste it in. Okay, now obviously that's all come out in the wrong size. So I'm just going to select that and set that all back to paragraph. You want that to be paragraph. And of course, in this case, you don't want that to be blue. You definitely want that to be black, the text. But we got our intro there, okay? Introduction, all with a nice color. And then I'd come down again, and if I've got, say, aims of unit. Again, I'm going to make sure this is really consistent. So I'm going to select that, come up again. I always use these headers because it keeps it safe in terms of the sizes, etc. Again, select that, make sure I choose the correct color, click in here on the side. And then again, I would add my text in underneath here. Again, I'm just going to copy some text really quickly. So I've just grabbed some text. If I make sure I click on paragraph first before I paste it in, then I won't get the problem that I had the time before. Then now if I paste it, it should come straight away in on the right one. Now the only thing is, again, select that, and this often happens. Come back and make that sure that that is heading 3. Right, we've started to get a kind of nice look and feel. Nothing special, but nice and clear. Let's have a quick look and just save the changes and just see a little bit what it looks like. Okay, so see how the unit is building up. Now, what would be really nice now probably would be to have a video here, and you can either embed the video from your YouTube channel, or you can just upload a video. So I'm gonna just embed the video from the YouTube channel. Now again, keep in mind what I'm doing here. I'm adding all this into that introductory part, and this would be the end of it. Underneath then I would have the links to the content itself. So let's just add a video in. Now it's pretty easy to embed a video from YouTube. I'm gonna show you a couple of tricks. Just come to a YouTube video, it's one from my channel. I'm gonna click on share, the share button underneath the video, and then I click on embed, and then I click here, okay? And what I can do is I can copy that text and then come back to my website. Sorry, wrong page, this one here. And we're on edit, so we're editing this content. And we're gonna jump into the HTML code. I'm just gonna come right to the bottom and paste that in. Now I'm gonna show you a little trick here. This video is 560 by 315, and I might wanna make that video a bit smaller, it might be too big. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna knock off about 20% of the size of the video. So that means I'm gonna take off about 100 10% of that is going to be 56 pixels, and 20% is going to be about 112 pixels. So I'm just basically going to take that down to about 450. It doesn't have to be exact. And the same here. So 10% would be 31, 20% would be basically 60. So if I take that down to about 250, okay, so I've resized the video as well, and now I'm going to update. Really simple to do that, and you'll see why in a minute, because it'll just look a lot nicer because the video won't be too big on the screen. There it is, my first unit of my course, where I've got my link here, the title, nice title, correct colors, and then afterwards I've got my first video. Okay, I really hope so far that's been useful. Just very simple things, but they really do make a difference. Now, what I want to point out to you now, and we're going to do this in another video, is that what we can have here at the bottom is a button that takes us to a book format. And very few teachers use the book format. When I do training in Moodle, I often find that teachers don't realize how the book works. I'm just going to show you a book example. We've got this course here, the one that I was showing you earlier, and if we come down to the first unit and click on this first button, it takes us into a book. And a book basically means that we can go through the pages of content. And then once we've come to the end, we can go back again. And the only thing that we need in the book is the ability to come back to the home page. That's all you need. So a book format allows you to have various pages. And if you'd like to learn more about the book format, I'm going to offer you a link now at the top of the screen and at the end of this, right at the end of this video, to go on to part two and to learn about the book format. And again, we're going to try and make it look quite nice. So really hope that was useful. And if it was, please like the video, please share the video. Please comment if you've got any questions about Moodle, and please, if you can, subscribe to the channel. And thank you very much. If you're looking for more videos on Moodle, please come to teachertrainingvideos.com. Come over here to the section on Moodle. Lots of videos up there about Moodle. Just click on any of them. If you want to follow my work, keep up with my webinars, with my new videos, with my online courses where I'm presenting face-to-face. I always put a link to the face-to-face presentations anyway. But if you want to keep up with all that material, my blog posts, etc., then please sign up to the newsletter. And if you're looking for all the backdated content, then I would really suggest subscribing to YouTube and clicking on the bell. That way you'll also get updated about the new videos that go up onto YouTube, and then you get access to all the backdated content. If by any chance you're looking to invite me to do a talk for you, or if you'd like me to do some training with you, either one-to-one or one in a group, then please just connect with me. You can contact me from the website. And thank you very much.